All right, so back to my series here. This is like, absolutely, I make this a series, Reasons for Crying a Little. Well, my gosh, for a man, it could very well be that the woman that he desires, is not naked in the window as he drives up in his vehicle. That's a funny one. Does he cry? Do men even cry? Like inside, internal? I don't know. I think, what do you call it? I don't know. It's like overload, an overload system of availables, I suppose. I suppose many men have an overload system of availables. And so thusly, because of this, there's no reason for tears. Women sure are giving. I know it's so because women are so giving. Yeah, why would they have an overload in their system of frailty, you know, a fragility, a moment of where they feel fragile, you know, in their person, you know, why would they have it? Yeah, so the whole deal with, you know, the man and his monster of testosterone and you know, that embodiment male syndrome. Yeah, the women are supplying, so then he's always bolstered, isn't he? He's always bolstered, and there's never going to be fragility there. No. There's not going to be that. Yeah, so it seems kind of like a callous situation. Yeah, I'm not really sure how I can ever even enter into this race where there's a man and there's a woman. I'm not even sure how I can really enter into it for a long-term situation because of this. If the men are not frail in any way, shape, or form, emotionally, yeah, if they're always given, they're always supplied, yeah, it's kind of a broken record of give up, you know. We just might as well give up, you know. They're always supplied. You know. Yeah, and the female that actually says no, what do they do to her? What do they do to her, you know? Well, anyway, so yeah, we're dealing with I don't know, the immensity of some could say it's the male ego, itself, picking and choosing and delinquentizing certain females, turning us into their ordainment. Yeah, I ordain this woman this or that woman that. Very quickly in a generalization. Tough one. It's a tough one when I stick around a while, isn't it? It's a tough one. Because I'm not something you can just generalize any longer. Sorry about that. Hurry, 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 hurry. Give me the deadly vitamin C and kill me off or something, you know. Because after a while, you know, she's still here. So in the man's mind, he has to rearrange and change into what? This is not a generalization female. I can't just say she's this. I really wanted to just say she was that, you know? So easy. What was his reasons for crying if you were the man? Oh my gosh, no, I'm still not there. Wait, hold on. I have a moment. I may catch the cat. How about that? Oh, shoot, come back here. Come back here. Oh, forget it. Forget it. She will not be caught. So anyway, I did try the chips and the pesto, and it's delicious, actually. It's very delicious. It would be better though with that spinach dip. We used to have those at the parties, spinach dip. And yeah, anyway, yeah. So that's right. Reasons for crying if you're a man? I guess so. Maybe they cry because they have to work out, or they didn't work out. Maybe that's it, you know. And I'm like, well, that's me generalizing. The men is something about them and their physical state, you know, not being beauteous, you know. Yeah, I don't know. Oh, entrapment. Entrapment. That would be a reason, yeah. What? They're entrapped. That's another reason they cry. Inside, yeah. What else? What else? What else? Oh my gosh. I don't know. I don't know. I guess I'm tired. I can't really, you know, wonder for the men. Yeah, my insides are starting to gurgle with corn chips, but I'll eat more. Don't worry. I have like an entire. I'm so depressed tonight. Don't worry. I'm so depressed. I'm gonna eat all of these corn chips. See all those? I am that depressed.